I played that your thing, which is
Kung Fu. Yeah. And then what were you doing against that? When you.
Been working with that, like,
that's a good one.
As a bell, the bass, and the bass I use is just 9-1.
Oh yeah.
Like, for a lot of stuff. Sideway drum a lot. Let's see, so what? That's the first that is. It starts right after, because that's like the bum dip is like 7-8. But it sounds good right here. Pop. 9 though, like I can feel the, like I've been doing the 5 a lot as like, either like trying to hear the bell in my head, you know, the, because I got so used to, I started going, I'm trying to put like a pulse on the bigger 5, going like right. 2 and 4. Patterns like
for sure.
the whole Milford thing is like you take like you just have to start thinking in milliseconds and pull back instead of like factor 128 factor 256 to try to create patterns that have those little details in there like a heartbeat. And when he first said nature, I like went, nah, it sounds right, but it doesn't make a lot of sense. And 3 years in, I'm kind of going, okay, I kind of get how I can like fashion counter stress patterns like that 5 thing. That's like I'm not got my head in it a ton to make it sound, but you can get it to where you can get the you can get the full, you know, the full Ben Fowler. And get that full 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to where a melody starts cycling, and if you count the bigger pulses like 10, you can get a boom pinky da da
doo
you know. And then you're kind of hearing on two different on those different levels.
Yeah.
And that's a big thing of the Milford thing is he does like if he's doing like a the double time pulse into the like just in a I got a bunch of this. We should have you take photo shots of him over here. I took pictures of lots of his like drum diagram, like his X's and O patterns. But like if it's just like basically, you just start thinking in terms of milliseconds, maybe find a computer program where you can like map out and you look at the heartbeat, and at first it like looks too complicated to get all those little details, but it's like if you relax, you go, oh, this must be the same place the Haitian thing is coming from. Instead of this kind of linear thing, like it's like a thing that has all these little teeny little details in there that make little millisecond details that make all the difference. Same as that. Thank you.
about time was like, I think toward the end of school, toward the end of college, when I spent a long time learning to play everything backward, like learning to read through the Art of Bop drumming, right hand lead instead of left hand lead.
Okay.
And using offbeat triplets, offbeat pairs of triplets all the time instead of the ride cymbal pattern. After doing that for a while, I would just improvise.
Yeah, I remember when you were doing like 2-3, 2-3 is the ride symbol, right?
Mm-hmm. And I think after that, after going through that process, after that being a big part of what I was practicing for a year or two, when I would improvise, I would start to get this freedom of like being able to keep one hand very much in time and have the other one like play off it in really abstract ways, like anticipating it or delaying, you know, following it in a delayed fashion and playing with that delay and stuff. And that was, you know, that was a way to like get
out
of time.
I remember you describing a lot of that and like the way you and him talk, think about it, and you talking about one holding and one
leaving.
Puppy hand roams and the other one holds tight. Like you both talk in a lot of the same language about